Good morning and welcome to this news conference. My name is Norman Solomon. I'm a co-founder and coordinator of the online group RootsAction.org, which is hosting this event today. Roots Action is a co-sponsor of a petition campaign calling for, and this is the title of it, No U.S. Warplanes Over Syria. Together with five other organizations, Veterans for Peace, Daily Kos, The Nation Magazine, World Beyond War, and Watchdog.net. The U.S. government began bombing Syria nearly 3 years ago. That was back in September 2014. Since then, the killing from many sides has continued unabated. Meanwhile, during the last 3 years, tensions between the world's two nuclear superpowers have escalated, and escalated sharply. In the process, Russia and the United States have come closer to direct military warfare with each other. When addressing the overall tensions between the United States and Russia, former Senator Sam Nunn, who was chair of the Senate Armed Services Committee, co-signed a letter recently, and I'd like to quote from it. It called for urgently pursuing practical steps now that can stop the downward spiral in relations and reduce real dangers, unquote, between Russia and the United States. And the open letter emphasized, again quoting, reducing nuclear and other military risks. Yet those risks continue to accelerate. That is the subject of this ongoing petition campaign, and that is the subject of our discussion here today. On June 19th, U.S. and Russian planes reportedly flew within 5 feet of each other over the Baltic Sea. Also, as this summer began, the U.S. military shot down a Syrian government jet, after which the Russian government threatened to shoot down U.S. planes over Syria. More recently, on July 30th, the New York Times reported that between the United States and Russia now, except for in relation to Syria, quote, there is virtually no military-to-military conversation of the kind that took place routinely during the Cold War. And the Times also said, with Russian and American forces both operating near the Baltics and off the coast of Europe, the chances for accident and miscalculation are high. The Times also described the communications between the Russian and U.S. militaries about their activities in Syria as, and quoting again here, mutually suspicious and sporadic. What's at stake here? As the United States continues its military actions in Syria, including in the skies over Syria, what is at stake includes the very real possibility that conflicts in the air could escalate into military clashes between Russia and the United States that could spiral into nuclear warfare. So, the petition campaign that is ongoing is focused on addressing this escalating crisis. Our petition so far to the U.S. Congress and to Secretary of Defense James Mattis has gained more than 50,000 unique signers, and the petition is very straightforward. It says, we urge you to immediately remove all U.S. military planes from Syrian skies and keep them out of that country's airspace. Today at this news conference, we're going to be hearing from four speakers who will address their concerns, our concerns, from a wide range of vantage points. John Kiriakou, former official of the Central Intelligence Agency, is a CIA whistleblower. Matthew Ho was a Marine who had two deployments in Iraq and later became a State Department official. Christie Edwards is a legal authority on international law as it pertains to armed conflict. And David Swanson is an author and the director of the organization World Beyond War. So we'll start with John Kiriakou. Mr. Kiriakou, as I mentioned, was a CIA official. He had major responsibilities with the agency. He went on to serve 2 years in prison as a CIA whistleblower. Back in December of 2014, a headline over an article by the Huffington Post really summed it up, a very apt summary. It said, "The one man jailed for CIA torture tried to expose it." John Kiriakou.